You have to kind of figure out what you want it to taste like and what blend will go with this and with that, what is the easiest to work with. And it is an unbelievable process, the whole chocolate world. I mean, you have to respect chocolate. You have to realize, and it's a she, that she's very temperamental. Just when you think that you've got it all down, she's gonna do something to you.
Chip Totkus is the owner and founder of Chubby Chipmunk Chocolates. It's a tiny yet eclectic candy shop found in between Lead and Deadwood. It's known for its mouth-watering homemade truffles. And the chocolatiers, well, they strive to become the best truffle makers in the land. They've even created their own ode to chocolate.
Tiana's ode to chocolate. It says, chocolate is the name, chocolate is the game. We live, breathe, and eat it. With it, our days are lit. It gets on our hands, clothes, and hair. In all honesty, it gets everywhere. We are exhausted when we're done from our play, but wake each morning ready for another day. Molding, dusting, scooping, and rolling, going along with what the chocolate is doling. When we run out, customers throw a fit, but in the end, they're always happy with what they get. This is our job, our passion, our means of life. A day without chocolate is cold and full of strife. No more sunshine or birds singing, only what sadness is bringing. But as soon as we see it solid or melted, songs of joy are then belted. We do it all day long, even in our dreams, dreams of butters, truffles, and creams. Now my song is done. I hope you had lots of fun reading it as much as I enjoyed writing it. I can't believe that we get paid to do this.
I can find a chocolate that anybody will fall in love with, and we always like to see people, they take it in their mouth, they close their eyes, and they swoon, sway, and sigh.
Seeing people happy comes easy for this former nurse, now chocolatier and business owner since 2005. Chip and the chocolatiers are always finding new flavors for the truffles. It's just one way this Chubby Chipmunk family is keeping their customers returning.
We have 51 flavors right now. So for Halloween, we have like a pumpkin cheesecake. For Christmas, we have maple and hot chocolate. For white chocolate, we have a buttercream and a creme brulee, which we've won some awards for. Also the New York cheesecake, key lime and lemon meringue, root beer float, which is my favorite. We have Bailey's Irish cream. We have Deadwood toffee, raspberry cream, strawberry princess, German chocolate cake and Kahlua, our mousse toffee, which we've won awards for as well. Our milk mousse, milk caramel, milk peanut butter, Rocky Road turtle, the toffee and dark signature, mint monk, dark caramel, burgundy cherry almond, blackberry, amaretto, and black walnut, hot mama, which is a little bit spicy.
What's in the hot mama?
It has habanero, cayenne, jalapeno, and chipotle.
The Chubby Chipmunk is actually located in an old Sinclair gas station. Unusual, maybe. Creative, absolutely. And should you drive by during non-business hours, no worries. Truffles are available 24 hours a day in the Chub-O-Matic vending machine.
If I stop and think that when I first started, I bought 200 pounds of chocolate and was freaked out I would not sell that in 6 months. You know, to now, we ordered 10 or 4 tons of chocolate for the summer, and now it's like, oh my gosh, do we have enough?
These South Dakota candies have been eaten at the Country Music Awards and even the Grammys. They've even been written about in the Rachel Ray magazine. It has been a quick trip to success for this South Dakota company, especially when experts told Chip that no one would buy a candy from a company with the name Chubby in the title.
Well, my nickname is Chip. When I wanted to open a little shop, it had to have the word chipmunk in it, and my mother said, well, Chubby Chipmunk, it'd be cute. Actually had marketing people tell me I couldn't call it that because it had the word chubby in it, and they go, no one's going to come in and buy chocolate from you if it says chubby.
You're welcome. Enjoy your chocolate. We'll see you later.
Chip's passion for chocolate has even taken her to Peru, where a chocolate bean thought to have been extinct since 1916 was recently discovered and turned into one of the rarest chocolates made today.
It's a very earthy, pure chocolate. It is a dark. It was the chocolate, actually, that 95% of all the people in the world ate in the 1800s. The Fortunata number 4 is the chocolate that they found, and it is named after the man who owns the little farm, Mr. Fortunato, And number four is the fourth sample that was sent for DNA genetic testing.
My favorite part about being here every single day is sharing our truffles with people because they love them. It's so easy to share it with people. There's not a sad person in sight. You know, they walk in here and they're like, oh, I feel so much better now that I'm here.
That's what I want to do, is have a food item, especially chocolate, that people can be absolutely in love with and get back to a time when food was delicious.